Hi friends, welcome back to the Carbon Classes channel, and today we are going to talk about the cerebral sulci and gyri. This is the lecture 2 of the playlist that we are going through, that is the cerebrum. And in this lecture, friends, we are going to talk about the gyri and sulci. And basically, friends, we would cover the gyri and sulci present in the frontal lobe, and plus we are going to talk about what is gyri and sulci in this video. So friends, let's get started. And before starting, friends, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, so please go and subscribe. And if you haven't liked our videos, if you do like them honestly, so please give us a like icon, please press the like icon. And if you do want to support us, our Paytm link is down in the description. Please go and help us out. So let's begin with the today's lecture, basically dealing about the cerebral sulci and gyri. So talking about gyri, friends, gyri, your cerebral cortex is folded into folds, which is called gyri. And your gyri are these are separated by sulci. So cerebral folds are cerebral cortex is basically folded into some folds, which we are calling gyri, and sulci basically separates the gyri. So definitely, friends, you would understand more about the sulci and gyri when I'm going to talk about them when I'm going to explain different sulci and gyri. So basically, basic definition is gyri are your cerebral cortex is folded into gyri, and these gyri are separated by sulci. And basically, what are sulci? Sulci, these are structures that separate the gyri. Now talking about the total area of cerebral cortex, so the total area of cerebral cortex is 2000 centimeters square. So the total area of cerebral cortex is 2000 centimeters square, and out of which 2/3 of area is hidden from the surface within the sulci. Now the formation of sulci, in the intrauterine life begins in the 5th to 6th month and ends almost at the end of 9 months. So friends, the formation of sulci in the intrauterine life begins in the 5th to 6th month and ends almost at the end of 9 months. So it takes 3 months for the sulci to develop. So friends, looking on the structure, we have the superior lateral surface of the cerebral hemisphere. So basically, it is important to know the different parts of the superior lateral surface of cerebral hemisphere, as it is important because we are going to deal with these different sulci and gyri present in the areas. So firstly, we are going to know about the structures which are present over here. So basically, this is your frontal lobe. This is your frontal lobe over here. And behind the frontal lobe, friends, we have got the parietal lobe. So over here, this is the parietal lobe. This lobe, friends, over here is the temporal lobe. And behind the temporal lobe, we have got the occipital lobe. Friends, these are imaginary lines which are separating these lobes. The lines which I made in dotted pattern are the imaginary lines which separate these lobes. And this dark line over here, which you can see, is the central sulcus. So this dark line present over here is central sulcus. This is the central sulcus. So this is all about the structures we can see in the superior lateral surface of the cerebral hemisphere. Now friends, we are going to shift to the next topic, where we are going to talk about the sulci and gyri present in the frontal lobe. So friends, as you can see, we have drawn a superior lateral surface of right cerebral hemisphere over here, and in this we are going to explain only about the your frontal lobe. So your frontal lobe, and this is the parietal lobe. So frontal and parietal lobe is separated by a sulcus, which is called the central sulcus. So most important sulcus is over here. This is the central sulcus. Now talking about the different sulci which are present over here. So guys, basically three sulci are present over here, which are namely precentral sulcus, superior frontal sulcus and inferior frontal sulcus. So first we are going to talk about them. So talking about the frontal lobe, it has got three sulci. First one is your precentral. Next one is your superior frontal, and the last one is your inferior frontal. Friends, now we are going to talk about its location. So this is the central sulcus. So central sulcus, your precentral sulcus would definitely be located behind the central sulcus. So this is the location. So as you can see, this one is your precentral sulcus. Now this is the superior frontal sulcus and this is the inferior frontal sulcus. So this one is your superior frontal sulcus and this is your inferior frontal sulcus. Nextly, we are going to talk about the gyri which are present over here. So for gyri, I would preferably use a different colored pen. So gyri in the frontal lobe, so basically these there are, depending on these lobes, sulcus, friends, there are different types of gyri. Firstly, the area which we can see over here, the area between the central sulcus and precentral sulcus, this area is termed as precentral gyri. So precentral gyri. So let me label it precentral gyri. Now your superior frontal sulcus and inferior frontal sulcus divides the frontal lobe into three parts, three gyri basically. So the first is superior frontal gyri. So this area over here is superior frontal gyri. The middle area is middle frontal gyri. The middle area is middle frontal gyri, and the area below totally is inferior frontal gyri. So let me label them superior frontal. Now the next one is middle frontal, and your last one is inferior frontal. Now basically, friends, in inferior frontal gyri, it also, this whole gyri is inferior frontal gyri. So your inferior frontal gyri contains two sulcus. Your inferior frontal gyri contains two sulcus. Basically, this is the lateral sulcus. So this prominent sulcus over here is the lateral sulcus. So let me label this prominent sulcus over here is the lateral sulcus, and that too, this lateral sulcus is in the posterior ramus. So this is the posterior ramus of lateral sulcus. So posterior, let me label it posterior ramus of the lateral sulcus. Now this lateral sulcus has two parts over here, which you can see. So one part is your ascending ramus and other is your horizontal ramus. So ascending and horizontal rami are present, are over here, over in the region of inferior frontal gyri. So this is your ascending ramus. This is your ascending ramus of lateral sulcus, and this is your horizontal. It is, friends, basically more horizontal. That is why it is named as horizontal ramus. Horizontal ramus of lateral sulcus. So friends, these ramuses, these divide the inferior frontal gyri into three parts. These three parts are basically pars orbitalis, pars triangularis, and pars opercularis. Let me repeat: pars orbitalis, pars triangularis, and pars opercularis. So let me write the names for you guys over here. Your inferior frontal gyri is divided into, again, three halves or three parts, all starting with pars orbitalis. Second one is your pars triangularis. And your third part is pars opercularis. So guys, let me label these. So this part over here, or rather start from this part. So this part over here is pars orbitalis. So let me label this as pars orbitalis. friends, as you can see, this area is rather a more triangular shaped area, hence it is named as pars triangularis. So this part over here is pars triangularis, and lastly this part over here is your pars opercularis. So this one over here is pars opercularis. So friends, in this lecture we had talked about the various types of the sulci and gyri, the various types of lobes, and we had generally talked about the sulcuses and gyri present in the temporal lobe, present in the frontal lobe. So let's take next lobes in our next lecture. Thank you friends for watching. Keep subscribing the channel. Thank you friends. Have a nice day ahead.